Hey guys, and welcome back to another episode of Mass Effect Andromeda. This is the single player game that we have been doing for a while, guys, and for those of you who may have missed the last couple episodes, we have finally reached the planet in question, Eros, and we're going to be going down to the surface here in a minute. But before we do, guys, I've been doing a lot of multiplayer missions, and there's a few things that I kind of found in here that you guys might not know. Some of you probably will. You could do multiple missions in here at the exact same time, and the way you do that to get another team is you can kind of come into this little tab right here, and you can use the mission funds, which is what you get. You get 5 points, 5 mission funds for every multiplayer mission that you go on and you actually succeed on. You have to win the match. You also get a lot of money that you can then use to buy crates that will get you more people and better armor and weapons and mods and all that kind of stuff in the multiplayer mission. But if you want the mission funds, you have to actually succeed in those, and once you get those, you can buy another team. Now, there might be other ways to unlock these. You might be able to augment them later on in some way, but right now I just went ahead and bought one. It was 40 mission or funds to do that, and the next one is 80, so I don't know if it's going to double each and every single time, but it's very, very cool that you can do this. Now, one of the things that I also mentioned when I bought the next one is if you look on the right-hand side, when they do certain missions, they will get positive traits that the mission sometimes specifies. So this group that I have right here, Golf, is level 5. They've done several missions already. They've already gotten their heroic and they've gotten the remnant specialist. So that's going to increase their ability to finish off certain missions because they have those. The other thing it said is if they go onto a mission and they fail, they will get negative traits sometimes. So you got to be very, very careful with who you send out there. You don't want to be very willy-nilly about it. This team right here, I just got Oscar. I only got him up to level 2 in the very first mission. They got Rugged. So I'm, again, not quite sure what Rugged does, but I'm sure we'll figure that out as time goes on. Now, because we do have one of the teams that just finished, and then this team right here that is about to finish, and they're going to get a bronze loot box. So we're going to go ahead and open up the rewards from the other guys real quick, which is a bronze credit loot box and a bronze material loot box. So let's see what we get in there. We get some credits, and what are we going to get from this one? Beryllium. So we'll go ahead and close that down. You can see 22 credits and plus 10 beryllium. It's nothing fantastic, but it is bonus stuff that you can get to kind of maybe augment what you got. Now, once you have 10 or 15, I don't even know how high it goes up onto the missions, you'll be able to get a lot of that stuff. You just kind of send them all off.
Oh, how'd you get under there?
Suvi, were you talking to your notebook?
Oh, I was, wasn't I? I do that sometimes.
So, yeah, they have different conversations when you come in here sometimes, and you can just sit here and listen to them. I do like how wherever planet you're on, you can look out the windows and you actually see the planet outside them. It's not a default image. They actually designed it so that you would feel like you're in orbit over it. So without any further ado, guys, let's go into the galaxy map. We're going to look at the planet in question, activate scanners.
A mirror of the signal on Habitat 7. Possible atmospheric manipulation.
Is that possible?
We'll find out. If it is like Habitat 7, no doubt we'll run into the cat.
Alright, so a desert world with significant resources, Eos is often wrecked by deadly radiation contaminant storms, cataloged as non-viable after numerous attempts to settle. Alert signal detected, similar to the device on Habitat 07. So you see over on the left-hand side, the missions that you have down here, A Better Beginning, Task, Lost Brother, and First Murderer. So the Better Beginning is the main storyline. The Lost Brother is somebody at the Nexus. Actually, I think it was on your ship. Somebody on your ship lost their brother on the way here, and he wants you to put his dog tags in one of his favorite spots. The First Murderer is somebody got killed down here. Not sure if it was a murder, if an accident, or if maybe something else kinky was going on, but we'll definitely look into all of that, and we're going to be doing the side missions first, just so you guys know. So without any further ado, guys, let's go into the landing zone. Do you wish to disembark the Tempest? Well, yes we do. Now, you can choose the weapons you have, and we did get a weapon. You can't unlock these because we don't have the combat fitness to do them. But we did get, I want to keep the machine gun. Let's look at the pistols we might be able to get rid of. I guess we're going to keep the Hornet. I would love to see them throw something in here so that you can try out the different weapons before you decide to take them with you. They don't really have anything like that right now. Yeah, like this one right here, you can kind of look at the details. Designed by the Milky Way Quarians, the Rigar Combine is effective against shields and radiates enough energy to harm enemies near the main target. An invisible laser ionizes the air and creates a path for a high amperage electrical shock. It was named for the Quarian Rigar in the recognition of his service against the Geth. Now, I have seen some people use this in combat, and it seems like it's okay. Is it fantastic? I don't know, but we could definitely give it a shot here in the future. For now, yeah, let's go ahead and do it. I mean, we got the machine gun, which is what we kind of stick with anyways, and I think that's going to be fine. Omniblade, we haven't gotten anything to upgrade that, so we're just going to stick that where it is. And of course, you can always add mods to it if you have any, and I believe we might have a shotgun mod to throw on here. So let's see, plus 10 shotgun damage, plus 10 melee damage. Now we're not going to go with that. And shotgun spare ammo. So I think we're going to go with the ammo and the shotgun barrel for extra damage as well. So let's say confirm loadout, and we should be good. Remember, you can change your group of people you're going to take down with you as well.
Hope we're all that ready.
So I'm...
All right.
Integrating search area from Sam. How he pulled that mystery signal through the storms, I have no idea.
Multisensory neural collision. Amazing.
Factory fresh across the board. Spinning up the compensators.
You're already tuning the displays.
We'll get a better read on this pass than the Nexus has had in months.
What?
I said a lot of people have their hopes pinned on us. They gave up on Eos. Can't blame them. Expected a golden world, instead they saw their friends die. Never know how that'll affect. Sorry.
Yeah, okay. Him losing that and kind of hearing voices seems very reminiscent of the first series of Mass Effect games where you kind of get infected by the Prothean technology and then you start like having memories unlocked inside you. I hate to say it, but it seems like they're just rehashing the same storyline over and over again with that. And they could have gone in like so many different directions that it's kind of a shame. Now, it's not a bad storyline, so I'm going to give it a shot. But yeah, at the first glance, I kind of wish they had done something a little different. So we got different choices here. I'm still feeling Dad's loss. I'm up for the adventure. It's my job as a new Pathfinder. The uncertainty ends with us. So very professional. Like, we got to get this done.
We didn't come millions of light years to die in a different place. I'm not letting the initiative down.
Pathfinder, the Tempest checks out. We're good.
Take us down.
You have no idea how long I've wanted a Pathfinder to say that.
I don't know, they all keep harping on the... They've been waiting for you, and like they all had the head, but why is that guy standing so close behind me?
Hell.
There. Set us down at this nav point.
Right.
What are we even supposed to do here?
Reports state this planet suffers deadly storms that are contaminated by radiation from the Scourge. Eos deployment was incomplete due to environmental hazards and ultimately hostile encounters.
Plus, no Pathfinder. If Eos is like Habitat 7, that signal we scanned must be connected with the atmosphere. We could use the outpost's antenna to track it down. Let's get the power back on. They must have known these wouldn't last in these conditions.
How would they know? They didn't have a Pathfinder.
They do now. We'll make Eos a home.
Man, I realize having like a military guy there to kind of find your home is a good idea to, you know, weed out all the threats, but it makes it sound like he's the only one that can do anything anywhere. And you have a group of very capable people on your side who are very, very interested in...
Structure up ahead. Sam?
It fits the profile of a power relay station, Pathfinder.
Right. We get it running, maybe buildings get power.
And we'll know where to look for that signal.
But yeah, it seems like they're very interested in making their own way down onto a planet. Like, they've all been waiting for it. And they have the equipment, they had the personnel, they just needed you, and it just seems very unlikely that it, like, one person would be the linchpin in that. Oh yeah, got a container already. AR stock, so 30% to assault rifle stability. That could be very, very nice for the right assault rifle. Those of you who have been watching the multiplayer aspect, there is an assault rifle in there that I got that is really, really powerful. Unfortunately, it's not very accurate at long range, so stability might help with that. Then again, it might not.
Huh. Guess that ship wasn't Ket then. They don't knock.
There are people here? We thought everyone left was gone.
Of course you did. Now shove off. Find your own salvage. This spot's taken.
Ooh. Who are you? I'm here to help. Let's tell him we're here to help, even though I would rather find out who he is first.
I'm not a salvager. I'm a Pathfinder. We've come to fix all this.
Call me Clancy. Pathfinder, huh? Like that changes much? The Nexus just can't let Eos go, can it? However much it fails down here.
I'm tracking a signal that will help Eos. I only need power for the antenna.
Look, I cut the power for a reason. The Ket are patrolling today. You turn the power relay back on, they'll know there's a juicy target alive down here.
Lead the Ket to me, but Eos could be saved. Let's tell him to leave the Ket to us.
Help me with the power relay, and I'll take care of the Ket.
You're crazy. Though maybe it's a good crazy. Okay. I'll enable the generators out there. You want to poke the tiger, it's on you.
He's still not going to let me in, though.
Expect trouble when we start the generators.
Yeah, but I think trouble is good. It gives me some experience, lets me level up, and maybe, just maybe, we'll get some loot off of those guys. But before we start up the generator, we're going to look around a little bit. We want to get our bearings on the situation, find out where things are, where we can come back to for ammo, such as that, and definitely where they can sneak up on us, because if we are going to get ambushed, which it sounds like there's a very, very good chance of that happening, I don't want to get taken completely off guard. Now, we do have our ship out here, and you would think the ship at some point... Ooh, we can collect stuff? Shiny. Oh, 73 out of that. Wow, look at that. They're just kind of laying out here in the open. That's a little weird, but they did say this was very rich with minerals, so I'm going to give them a pass on that, even though it's not what I like to see. I like to see it kind of mixed in, intermingled with the rock, maybe having to use, like, sonic detonators to get it out, like in real life, because, you know, usually you don't walk around the landscape and see just a bar of silver refined laying there on the ground for you. That would be amazing. I would love to live in a world like that, because then I could sell it and make some money off of it, and I wouldn't have to work, and it'd be very, very easy, but, let's see. Okay, so values for some of this, not too bad.
Looks
not
like
too
salvage.
Bad.
Salvage, new. Days ago, no.
Who else is here?
Well, we kind of already have an answer to that. We did already discover somebody, but I get where they're going with it. Like, maybe at this point you weren't supposed to already have seen that. Repair actuals. Okay, so very, very low on the price. What about in here?
It's
can we get inside?
Too long in this environment without power.
We didn't expect this kind of environment. Who could?
Well, you know, I get what they're saying, that they didn't expect it when they came to the galaxy, but they would have known before they landed. They have sensors. They have the ability to scan the planet. And of course, once they landed, before they put all these pieces here, they would have seen what was, you know, the environment was like. So it's kind of weird that they wouldn't have made modifications of some kind. Or maybe they couldn't. Maybe science just isn't there. They had to make do with what they had. Let's get a nice little view up here. I mean, we could jump over here. maybe we can take a look. Oh yeah, look at that. So there are some stuff inside. Or there is, there are, there might be, somewhere. Did I just go invis? Huh. Didn't know I could do that. I definitely don't do that in the multiplayer. I wonder what aspect is giving me that. I don't know, we're definitely gonna keep looking around though.
Getting emergency power, but it's code locked.
Site 1 issued individual security codes. Each outpost self-organizes and sets its own protocol.
Just say we can't open it without codes.
We can't open it without codes.
Yeah. You know, computers. They're very, very helpful to you guys. Oh, what about this? Now, you can't break through this glass, although I wish you could. And I don't even have the slam ability yet, huh? Or maybe I just because I don't have my melee weapon out. There we go. Yeah, didn't have my melee weapon out. Okay, so scanning all of this stuff.
This analysis provides us with important research data, Pathfinder. If you continue to scan and collect this data, we can utilize it to develop new technologies and upgrades for equipment, such as your weapons and armor.
Yeah, I'll definitely be coming back and scanning this in between videos. I don't want you guys to have to watch all of that. I'll scan here and there just so you guys can... Man, this place is huge. So that's where we need to go. I'm kind of going around in a circle, and we're almost there. Let's take a look out here on the outskirts. I think the shield... Ooh, what is this? Almost missed this. Definitely not one of mine. It is now, though. Is it not working? I can't even click on it. All right, well, so much for getting excited about a brand new ship. Definitely doesn't even work. What about the water? Now, this is one of the first times we've actually seen water that's deep enough that we might one day be able to swim in.
I think this is for purifying water.
It's huge and crooked. The storms did that?
Maybe. Wow, look at that. It's like they come apart. That's going to be very, very difficult to fix. Anything around here to scan? Nope, sure is not. All right, let's take a look around. Give me some loot, guys. Give me some loot. Still nothing. I like games that reward you for taking a look. Because you got to remember, a lot of the time, these little areas, these little nooks and crannies that somebody designed, somebody went through and spent a lot of effort to make sure they looked real, don't even really get used in the game. They have the main mission, and that's all that you're going to have. Is the shield not here? Oh, radiation.
Experiencing radiation damage.
Alright, let's get back.
Radiation within safe levels.
Wow, that would not have lasted very long. You can see my life support go down. Dramatic.
Life support restored.
Note to self, do not go in that direction. Oh, crate, crate, crate. And it looks like the door's open as well. Nickel, 100. Wow, we're getting a lot of resources off of that. Now, I've done a few of the missions with our strike team, and they usually only get, when the bronze packs are open, like 10 or 15 of the resources, so it's not a whole lot. So I'm kind of surprised I'm getting so much from these little tiny deposits down here. You wouldn't think there'd be a major amount of it. Oh, that data pad.
Got a code lock key.
Handy. It'll get us in.
Nice. About the terminal. Alright, audio log.
We suffered our first death today. Storm came out of nowhere. Lockley tried to cover our crops. Lost his footing. Got swept away. His wife is still in cryo. Maybe by the time they wake her up, I'll know what to say.
Log botany analysis. New entry. What are you hiding, Eos? The plants exhibit sporadic hypergrowth. Despite an environment that can sandblast paint, I'm starting to suspect an electromagnetic trigger. I detect a signal of some kind, definitely alien, but that's not my field. Uncertain if the deliberate vector noted. Okay, so we'll have to kind of check that out at some point. Because it'd be cool if the plants grow really quickly. I mean, we may not understand the technology, but if you can eat the plants, people back home, especially on the Nexus, they need the food, and they're going to be starving here pretty soon. So let's head back over here, see if we can get inside this room. I mean, for all we know, it's going to tell us we don't have enough power. There's, you know, a scan of your retinal or whatever, but we'll give it a shot. All right, so we're in. It's pretty deserted. Now, I understand they all had to leave for some reason, but they left it in a mess, man. Okay, so Solarian magnifier and leather wrappings. Just extra money that we can make and buy some good stuff with it. Now, I'm not really making any money.
The door had power, but not the interior doors?
Full functionality would require an active power relay station.
That means the antenna's out of power, too. Like the console said. Let's head to the relay station.
Oh, we'll get another terminal in here. Let's see. Message for Nick Theolopoulos? Why does that name sound familiar? Nick Theolopoulos. Is that the guy from the movie Godzilla, the one that took place in New York, I think? Theonopoulos or something. Maybe I'm mispronouncing it, but it's very, very close to what the other guy's was. People are talking here, saying that Eos isn't viable, that things aren't going like they expected. I think you should come back. I know what you're going to say. I didn't sign up for the initiative to stay trapped in a floating tin can. And I promise, you can have your adventure later, when they've had more time to plan for your safety. Mom told me to make sure you don't get in over your head, and that's what I'm doing. At least think about it, for me, and check in more often. I started to adopt Mom's worries. I always chewed through the nails of my pinky finger. It's up to you whether I keep the rest of my nails intact. Love ya. Okay, so, you know, got some people on here worried about their brothers and sisters and family. Sorry to bug you again. I requested an update on Leah Wells a few days ago, and I haven't heard anything back on my end. It looks like the message wasn't even opened. Is everything okay there? Get back to me as soon as you can, and tell Leah to message me back. Did not go very well. Apparently, she never got that message to stay safe. Something happened. Probably the Get attacked and maybe killed everybody. Maybe they took over. They did say they were kidnapping the people for something, and they might still be alive. Maybe we can have a happy reunion for them after all. Man, this place is huge. What do you got in here? What secrets are you holding? Anything at all? Ah, another terminal. Here we go.
I got a partial log, but I can't turn on the antenna. Something's blocking the power.
A remote lock is active. The interference originates from a nearby power relay tower.
So we're not the only ones interested in what happened here.
Let's check out this relay tower.
I wonder if that's the brother. That's actually over there in that building. 340 iron. Fantastic. That's amazing. Audio log.
Sandstorms, radiation. What the hell was Allison thinking sending us here? It's a hellscape. Farthingale's on my case to stay positive. Put on a brave face for the rest of the team. But I can't shake the feeling that I'm gonna die out here.
Might be a possibility. I don't know if we're gonna be able to save you or not, but we'll give it a shot. Let's see, flexible polymer. Okay, so just random stuff to sell. There's a lot of junk stuff just laying around. I wish there would be a little bit less of that. Maybe some stuff with backstories, notes, things of that sort in the canisters. I realize you got to give you money somehow, but maybe for helping people out. Maybe that's the way they could do money. Okay, let's see. We're going to keep going over to the right.
This place. It's a wasteland.
The radiation in Eos' atmosphere makes it difficult to cultivate life.
Radiation? Our suits protect against that, right?
Site 1 contains shield masts to dampen the brunt of contamination.
But if we go outside Site 1's perimeter?
That would not be advised.
Right, which we've kind of already did, just to kind of test out the waters, so to speak. Was not nice. Was not very forgiving out there. Okay, so we've checked all of these. I believe this is the next building on the list before we get back to that other one. Can we not open it? Ah, see, it lets you know when there's something to scan.
Pathfinder, that door is locked. Until power is restored, there is no way to unlock it or gain entry to these buildings.
All right, you guys want to be difficult. Gotta do the missions in order. Let's check out this building real quick. Ah, datapad and another one. Ah, login. Chief Engineer Grace Leto. New entry. Specialist Kiatrar needs to stop navel-gazing about the monoliths and whoever built them. We need that speculation mind of his. If it doesn't grow food, stop wind, or get Special Project Sigma done, it's not worth our time right now. His team is looking at the big structure, and they'll do good work. But I tagged his runner just in case. Vehicle tracking code, Gracie Delta 9. So we might be able to find his runner out there.
Another code, like we already found.
Okay, so I don't know what that means. Like two of them right next to each other? Lithium 120. Getting some resources, guys. Getting some resources. Omni gel canister 71. That's good because we're really short on some of the stuff we wanted to make. And the Omni gel was used in a lot of it. SR barrel. So we got plus 10 sniper rifle damage. Definitely take those. So this is going to be kind of cool. We're going to be able to actually do some research when we get back up to the, I'm going to call it the Normandy, but that's not what it's called. It's something else now, but pretty close to the Normandy. So we got our generator, prepare for our fight. In fact, let's go ahead and give it a save real quick, just in case.
There's an error in the startup sequence. Manual input required.
Damn it.
Please scan one of the pylons to determine a hackable input location. Generator interface possible. Location marked.
Okay, so we could do it on this one. Maybe? Shows it. Generator. Ah, we gotta be up here on the top, huh? I think we're gonna have to hit every single one of them, so maybe it was kind of a waste to go walking around since it sounds like we might have to do that anyways.
Sam, our friend Clancy, was he part of the outpost team here?
No, Pathfinder. According to Nexus records, he's stationed in the hangar bay.
So he used his clearance to sneak off the station, make some credits on the side.
Don't sound so impressed.
Yeah, not really. Oh, look at that. Holy crap, there's footprints in the sand. I didn't even notice that. That is pretty cool. They put a little bit of effort into that. I like it. And you get less footprints over here and more on this end, where it's a little deeper towards the water. That's cool. I like it. All right, let's move a little bit further in and see what's going on over here. Maybe interrogate this guy a little bit. She's definitely not straight-laced, but she gets the job done, I guess. Do we try opening this one? Nah, this one won't open either.
Pathfinder, that door is locked. Until power is restored, there is no way to unlock it or gain entry to these buildings.
Can we get up there? Seems to be like a balcony. Oh, that's the guy we already talked to. Okay. Let's go ahead and get this one.
We've got company.
Oh, sweet. Check it out. The landing. Get a little closer. Where are you guys at, my little precious? Oh man. Yeah, my machine gun is definitely not as powerful as the one I'm used to in combat now. Although my team's pretty good. They're moving up with me. Be aggressive. There.
The power relay station is ready for activation, Pathfinder.
That's it? Just four guys? I might have to bump it up to like hardcore or something just to give myself a little bit of challenge now that I've been doing all those multiplayer ones. Let's see, right up there, huh? Well, it is a small outpost. Maybe they thought nobody was going to be here, so they left a very small strike team around.
You took down all those Ket?
Sure, use the power relay. Hell, take whatever you like. Word of advice, though. If that signal of yours is out past the perimeter, you'll need a ride.
A ride?
Shuttles aren't fun in these winds. You need wheels. I think they kept a little something in storage.
And you didn't take it? We're gonna accuse them?
Didn't get around to salvaging it yet?
I tried. It ain't that simple. Might be easier for a Pathfinder, though. We're heading to our shuttle. Keep this up. Maybe next time we'll find more than just salvage around here.
Oh, so logical. Salvage, do you buy and sell? Or get to a safe location? Very emotional.
Go on. We'll take it from here.
I guess Crazy Blue has to buy her parts from someone else.
Crazy Blue, huh? Let's see if there's anything to scan. Doesn't look like it. Alright, outpost power controls. Let's go ahead and activate those. Power relay controls. Power control is on standby mode. Press to activate.
Power restored. We should have access to everything in Site 1 now, right, Sam?
Correct. Plus, I've located the source of the signal we detected in orbit. It's coming from the large alien structure just beyond Site 1. The structure appears almost identical to the one your father used to adjust the atmosphere on the previous planet. It's worth investigation.
Yes, absolutely.
That almost feels like a lead. Damn right it's worth investigating.
A warning. Radiation levels beyond the perimeter of Site 1 are well above acceptable limits. You cannot proceed without additional protection.
All the more reason to see if that alien structure can make a difference to this planet. Come on. We better find that vehicle Clancy mentioned.
Viability. Acquire 73 Andromeda viability points.
We can investigate the nearby buildings.
Okay, there was something else over here a second ago, wasn't there? Maybe there's just two different ways to turn that power on. There we go, container. M8 Avenger. I think we already have that, but you can salvage those. You can take them apart and maybe use the pieces to make your own. Repair actual. So yeah, we're going to give up those as well. Nothing else in here, huh? I'm really surprised that guy didn't take the weapon while he was stuck in here. I mean, you know, you got Ket outside. Nobody's here. He's a scavenger, so why is there anything left? I do not know, but it's kind of interesting to see how that's working. How about we try downstairs? Oh, yeah. Again.
Walls could talk.
Actually, with enough sensory data, I might be able to reconstruct an image of the past.
Seriously? You can do that?
Normally, it would be impossible. But since this is an initiative building, I have access to a multitude of data and arrays.
Let's give it a shot.
I could provide analysis via the scanner, Pathfinder.
That's pretty cool. It's almost like what she did. Oh my god, look at that. Huh. Let's see if maybe we can hear him talk, too.
It actually worked. Is there audio?
Compiling now.
There is.
We can't survive another attack. The storms and radiation were already killing us. Now we've got those things.
We can't return to the Nexus with our tails between our legs. The whole station is counting on us.
Then they're counting on corpses.
Damn, that's grim.
Not necessarily, not true. Because most of them probably did die. Alright, let's check out the terminal.
Wilcox thinks I'm crazy, but I know what I saw. Eyes on the mountain, watching us. We're not alone out here.
This log was recorded a day before the first Ket ambush on Site 1.
The Ket scouted them out.
Well, should listen to what he was saying. Alright, get some out of that. Resources that we can use. And that is pretty much all we have in here, so... Unfortunate. Not a whole lot of backstory for such a big building. Now, I am kind of reminded of one of the early buildings, and I believe it was the first one, where when you first landed on Eden Prime, they had people kind of stuck in buildings, and you could talk to them, and some of them wouldn't come out, and you could coax them out a little bit here and there, but very, very much like that in a lot of ways. It was supposed to be a giant success, and didn't quite turn out that way, and this is kind of the same thing. It was supposed to be a big success and ended up turning out anything else but.
Pathfinder, I have enough sensory data to reconstruct an image. I could provide analysis via the scanner, Pathfinder.
There they are.
You step outside recently. There's nothing golden about Eos.
Not saying there won't be challenges, but we can do this, Wilcox. We have to.
It's like we're listening to ghosts.
Or science. Let's see. Repair actuals, terrain rivets. All very, very low on the price scales right now. What exactly is that? I guess it's scientific equipment.
Changing positions.
Not what I wanted you to do. All right, so that's all that's in this room. Not a whole lot. Check that area. Let's go ahead and check this one. Oh, no, I think we've already went in there, didn't we? Yeah. Let's keep going over here. So there was one room or one door that we got open, and it said you wouldn't be able to get into the other side until there was power. And I think this was it over here, where we could go left, but we couldn't go straight. So let's give this one a shot and see if now maybe we can open up this door right here. Alright, got more. Any little tidbits of story? Ah, here we go, terminal. Log supply situation. Logging, technician K. They divided the rations again. Tonight's menu, soup, with a couple of crackers each. Hope we're not too hungry to prop up the south building tomorrow, but there's nothing else for it. Can't forge because the weather's deadly, can't grow crops in those winds, and the Nexus can't feed us and themselves. No, don't think about it. There's talk going around of getting back to the Nexus, but we can't find an answer. Who can? We dare to put our boot prints here. We were the first. Me and Theo promised to stick it out, even if we end up being the last. Well, at least they had the drive.
All the challenges, and the colonists still tried to tough it out.
They didn't know what they were in for. They weren't told.
Sam and I could have helped them. This won't happen again.
It's not like they had much choice. I mean, even if they had gone back, it would have been pretty much the same situation. They didn't have any food up there either, and now they're kind of begging us to get them food, so not a great choice either way.
Special requisition all-terrain scout rover.
A Nomad, six-wheel drive, jump jets, just what you need.
The Initiative only built a few.
This must be what Clancy meant.
The crate required.
Oof. Okay, well, we kind of skipped over that because I opened up the door.
Well, what do you know? The outpost research center is still intact.
Updating the Tempest on this critical recovery.
Research was always key to the Initiative. We'll need it here, too.
Now we're building again. This is vital to our progress.
This tech is how we survive in Andromeda. Ingenuity on the ground.
Someone else agrees. This research center was used recently to monitor the alien signal.
This gives us the tools to find the source, and maybe whoever else is looking.
I do apologize, guys, that that conversation was cut off a little short. That sounded like a gunshot. Senior foreman tried out the new pen design on the shelters today. Only time will tell if they actually hold together when the next storm rolls over. At least it should be easier to find the pieces this time. Shorty's pinching for a evac back to the Nexus. Too many ket, not enough water, no hope, he says. I'd rather sell supplies and sleep on the deck than lie awake listening to the storms one more night. Can't say I disagree. Losing three of my guys to the ket made me wonder about leaving too. But I asked him what I asked myself. What's back on the Nexus for Pioneers? Isn't Eos what we signed on for? It has to be, in log. So, you know, I liked the sound of storm, so I would definitely be the one that was like, I don't want to go back to the silence. I'll stay here and listen to the horrible, horrible storms. There's a movie called The Martian, and he's sitting there just watching the flap when his thing blows out. He's listening to the storm, and it's just getting to him. I listen to that, and I'm like, this sounds beautiful to me, so very, very weird in that regard. Coolant cells, yes, please. They're high value. We'll take that, please. Container? Give me something good. Element Zero. Yes. That is one of the first Element Zeros we've really gotten lately. Active power relay, let's turn that sucker on.
The research station is back online. I've provided a list of weapons we can build by gathering the required components.
Alright, call down a forward station, clear atmospheric radiation. Let's go ahead and give it one scan over. Do apologize if I went a little too fast there, guys. You might get a little dizzy. Let's see if we can get inside. Oh, there's a keypad right there.
No good. The forward station should have the access code, once we call it down.
Okay, so we gotta call that down anyways. Let's head on back over to that direction. And you can see there's a vehicle here of some kind at one point. However, you would think the wind blowing through.
Automated forward station deployment.
Forward stations are auto-deployed from orbit at approach sites. Press that to observe. Forward stations are fast travel locations and a place something something. Didn't quite get to see it.
Looks like the forward station supplies are intact.
Downloading Nomad Crate access code.
Alright, let's look at the terminal. Forward station protocol initiated. Present viability metrics mismatched. Habitat 1, named Eos, does not match initiative pre-flight profiles. Advanced pre-detectives are no longer applicable. 94% rework. Nothing that I really need to know. Fallout from Scourge is exceptionally violent on contact with equally aggressive decline. Okay, that's nothing there. Let's see. More gibberish. Planet-wide climate uniformly is unlikely to have occurred naturally. Right. Unlock the Normand Nomad container. Jeez, yeah, if I could read tonight at all. Clear the atmospheric radiation. I'm not quite sure how you do that. I'm sure it's going to be a building of some kind down the road. Somebody inside, or is it remote controlled? This is the remote control that you can get if you order like the Bextra bonus pack of the game. One of them is just a toy that you can put on your shelf, and one of them is actually remote controlled, made out of metal and has like all the coloring and everything on it. It looks pretty cool, but this is it. This is, you're gonna be able to drive it around. Let's look at our journal here real quick, because I want to see what it means. Not the codex, let's go back. Better beginning. Oh man. Yeah, exit that. Here we go, journal. A better beginning. Toggle. Speak with the ship. Unlock. Here we go. Aliens, additional task. Collect area resources to craft a weapon. Path of the hero, meet Carrie. So we haven't done any of those yet. So that's pretty much it. Priority ops. Yep. That's all we need to know about. All right. So let's go ahead and get inside.
The Nomad should handle pretty smooth. Check both forward and reverse, would you?
Life support system can protect from the hazards longer than your combat armor, but not for an unlimited amount of time. The Nomad will begin to take damage once life support fails. Am I leaving a trail behind me? I sure am. That's cool. All right, let's head out into the distance here.
Detecting above normal radiation levels.
There's something out there. I would love to be able to just kind of go out there and look around, but let's stick to the path for now until we figure out how this thing works.
I can't get traction. It's too steep. Switch to six-wheel drive. It'll get you up there in a snap.
How do you switch to six-wheel drive? Nope, that did not work. Let's go all the way back down. We'll do another run on that.
Radiation levels within acceptable limits.
Aw, oh, come on, turn. Oh, come on, do it. Oh my god, so close. Alright, I suck at driving this thing. It's official. Let's back it up, get a nice run at this. Alright guys, let's give it one more shot. Hopefully we can do this. Maybe the boost and the jump will be just enough.
Radiation levels have spiked, Pathfinder. Within safe levels.
This is ridiculous. Left bumper. Alright, so left bumper did something. We'll see if that made a difference. Okay, so yeah, left bumper is what you needed to use.
Remember the Nomad's jump jets. They'll get you over most obstacles. If you need more juice, the boosters can accelerate you out of trouble.
Okay, it seems like there's some enemies out here. What is that? Can we get out?
Got it. Signal's coming from that structure up ahead.
I bet you can extend these force fields later on. So it's a lot slower, but I guess it has more power. Let's see what happens if I go out of here.
Detecting above normal radiation levels.
You know, I can survive a little bit of time out there. You can kind of see it on the bottom left corner. Again, guys, do apologize for the vehicle. Yeah, it took a little bit to get used to. It's the first time I've ever used that vehicle at all. Haven't tatted it in the multiplayer. That would be cool, though. Have vehicle play in the multiplayer.
I'm picking up initiative tech nearby from above us.
There, look, up near that scaffolding.
Let's check out the alien device first.
It's working, but I'm just getting random symbols. Glyphs.
With more glyphs to expand my database from Habitat 7, I could interface fully with the console.
And hopefully start up whatever helps the atmosphere.
I could provide analysis via the scanner, Pathfinder.
Okay, well you're not really. It tells me a little bit about it right there on the left, but... Let's see, how do we get up there? It was right where I was a minute ago, right there next to all that scaffolding.
Enough to carry heavy equipment up there.
Too sophisticated for a salvager. Who else is studying this place?
That should complete the glyphs, Pathfinder.
Oof, that actually looked like it might have hurt.
Building connection. I apologize for any discomfort. The system seems unstable.
This is what happened when my dad tried doing this?
Your father interfaced directly with the atmosphere processor. That proved extremely hazardous. These structures could reveal its control center. System remains unstable. Doubling our power input might accelerate the process.
I'll give it a shot.
Wait! Back up. Literally. Whoa! Yeah. Easy. You've come this far. Just let it ride. I've been studying this tech for months. I don't know how you activated those glyphs, but you have to let them cycle through their channels. It's going to be all right. Trust me, okay?
So I did have the option to push her off if I wanted to.
I know. Who am I? I mean, it's obvious who you are. I saw the ship swoop in. You're a Pathfinder. I was beginning to think the initiative just made you guys up so the rest of us wouldn't lose hope, but You're for real, huh?
You think? Or what about you?
Are you for real? You were going to tell me who you are.
I might just be the solution to all your problems. Well, look at that.
System has stabilized. I'm establishing a connection.
Oh, crap.
I know these things from Habitat 7.
Later! Just take them out! Keep targeting that one! They make little bots!
Whoa. Oh, that's right. I'm using the new shotgun. That's pretty cool. I like that. Need a really good line of sight on him, though. Wow, look at the damage that does. Any left? Okay, so we got some stuff. I'm not really a big fan of how it pauses the game when that happens, but it is single player, so. Activate remnant monoliths, 1 out of 3.
Not bad. My first tangle with the remnant was a lot messier.
The remnant?
These monoliths, the observer and assembler bots. They're all the remnants of something much bigger. But that's too long. Ugh, I hate long. So, the remnant. Like, my name's better as Peavy.
Ah, good to meet you.
Thanks for helping with those things. I'm Ryder.
You're a mystery. I've been studying those glyphs for months, and then you arrive and... poof, solved.
I saw this tech clear the skies on Habitat 7. We're hoping it could do the same for Eos.
Huh. Atmosphere manipulation? Maybe. Fits the model. All remnant tech is connected. You interfaced with this monolith somehow, and now it's pinging the others. If you wake them up too, they must lead to whatever master switch might fix the radiation.
Let's see. That seems convenient for you, so we follow the thread.
Interface with the monoliths, follow the connection to the source. Easy enough.
Sure. Just don't piss off too many observers. Here. Take my nav points. I've got to figure this interfacing out. Just be careful. This planet's all kinds of strange.
All right, guys. Well, we're going to go ahead and end the episode here. On the next episode, we will be continuing our story here on the planet. I'm still kind of thinking there's a very, very big connection to the very first Mass Effect series as far as the Protheans and the storyline that went with that. Same thing here. You're kind of unearthing ancient technology. We went to a whole nother galaxy, and I was just kind of expecting like something new and not like rehashing the same story. And every single time it unlocks something along with our story so far, it seems to be going more and more and more down that path. So we'll have to wait and see. But as always, guys, I'm AC Gamer. Till next time. Hey guys, and welcome to the disembodied voice of AC Gamer. We are definitely going to be doing a lot more series in the future, but here are a few of them that you guys might find interesting. Of course, you're more than welcome to check them out. I would love to hear your comments. Again, if you do enjoy these videos, be sure to hit that like button, subscribe. It's definitely the indicator that I use to tell if you guys want to see more videos like that, of that particular game style, of that series in the long run. So when you guys leave comments down, it helps me decide whether we should keep doing it, as well as whether you want to see games like that in the future. And here are a few of them right here. I kind of picked out a few of different genres. We will be doing spotlights for other YouTubers in the future. So if you want to get a little shout out, definitely let me know. If you group with me, chances are you will get a shout out in here eventually. But for now, these are just four series that I have that I feel like could use a little bit more attention and that you guys might actually enjoy as well. Thanks again for watching, guys, and we will definitely catch you all next time.